Vault 88 emergency classification. Unspecified integrity breach warning. Any available Vault Tec personnel are required to respond under emergency protocol VT-76. This signal will repeat. Broadcast signal from Vault 88. Authentication code word, English. Vault 88 emergency classification. This is an emergency broadcast signal from Vault 88. Authentication code word, Impish.
Peace at once!
The
vault doors were meant to withstand a direct nuclear strike.
Any available Vault Tec
attempts to breach this facility are laughable. Leave at once, or there will be consequences. Vault Tec will not forgive this vandalism. First, lift the security lockdown and get to the reactor room. It's been hard to maintain the faith. So many years stranded here. But you can assure Dr. Glan that I have used the time productively. The great work is ready to begin. Good. Very good. Vault Tec workshops require their control board to function. During emergencies, the procedure is to store it in the reactor room. Look in there and you should find it.
Hey.
You aren't what I was expecting. You do have a Pip-Boy. You're from a vault. But you're clearly not with Vault Tec. What are you doing here? Why did you help me?
I heard the Vault Tec radio beacon, and I came.
Those intruders must have triggered it by attempting to force the main door. I wasn't actually expecting anyone to answer it. After all this time, my name is Valerie Barstow, and I was to be the overseer of this vault. But please, follow me. I have a proposal for you. It's been a hard 200 years. I was giving a tour of what was to be my pride and joy. My vault. Then, the earthquakes. Sirens. Many died. Perhaps they were lucky. Stop, Julie! What are you doing? Julie! What are you doing? Julie! The construction crew didn't fare as well as me. They've never done anything hostile towards me, though. It's probably best if you put them out of their misery. It's better to put the poor fellows out of their misery at last. I'll wait for you to finish. Do what you...
Picking up hostile life signs. Not this time.
Wait for you to finish.
At least that's over. Let's continue.
tried digging my way to the entrance. With that control board, I could have changed everything. But there was simply too much rubble for the equipment to handle. But my work kept me going. Here, among these papers, is my life's work. I'd like to share it with you. Dr. Braun tasked me with something vital. A series of prototypes and their related... well, experiments that could redefine society. But, as you can see, things did not go according to plan.
Go on, then.
This vault was meant to be spacious, full of trained staff, trusted subordinates and scientists. Despite how things have played out, I see opportunity. Let us work together, as partners.
What's my role?
I recognize that you are in a superior bargaining position. I'll handle the mundane nuts and bolts of vault management. Anything you want, I'm happy to accommodate. All I ask is you run the prototype experiments.
Let's do this, then.
Good. Excellent. We cannot begin until I have my overseer's desk to run the experiments. The information in the desk's terminal will prove vital. I entrust you with the future of our vault. Vault 88.
Excuse me.
I can hardly believe it. My overseer's desk. After all this time.
Hi.
This. Please, I beg your indulgence. I've waited so long. But we must not dally. The work compels us. The vault was supposed to have a very specific set of residents. After all, to conduct human trials, you need the perfect test subjects.
So what makes perfect test subjects?
Healthy. Well, healthy enough. And people we can get an accurate baseline on quickly. And they need a willingness to take on a certain element of risk.
After all these years, you don't want to leave?
When I finally have a chance to complete my mission? Never. It's all I've been thinking about, dreaming about, for hundreds of years.
Let's find ourselves a guinea pig.
The Vault Tec Handbook urges overseers to refrain from using that word, no matter how apt. Turn on the Vault's radio beacon. Certainly people above ground would give anything to live in our vault. While we wait for word to spread, perhaps you might use this time to explore Vault 88. If you can clear some of the rubble, you may be able to access some of the other building sectors. Any materials or equipment that survived may prove useful in our experiments. What a momentous day.
Yes.
Take care of that!
Yes.
Picking up hostile life signs. Not this time.
Thank you.
Feel free to explore. I'll keep an eye out for candidates.
Excuse me.
I think our first batch of residents is arriving. Hopefully, we have some new residents to greet. Soon. This will be a proper vault. I'll be with you in a moment. If you could all just wait over there.
A ghoul? I don't know about this.
Hi.
I never even imagined a place like this. I'll wait as long as I have to, ma'am.
Valerie.
Just a moment and we can begin. Please. Step forward. Ah, yes. Welcome. Welcome.
So, this here's a vault, right?
Quite correct. And you could be one of our lucky new residents.
You do got food in this vault, right?
Of course. And a chance at a new life. A question or two first, however. What do you think is the role of a good government?
Government? What the hell are you talking about?
It's all right. We're the good guys. Just answer the questions.
You seem... All right. Okay. From what I heard, them governments are why everything's radioactive.
You won't do for our special assignment. But welcome to our vault. Your new home. If she is representative of what's left above, the outside world must be rougher than I imagined. Are you ready for the next interview?
Why didn't she work as a test subject?
Skeptics and cynics rarely produce good data. No, we need someone willing to cooperate.
Would it kill them to at least prepare a resume? Heck, even a cover letter would do.
That would expedite the process. Well, next. Hello. Welcome to Vault 88.
This is a real nice place you have here. Real nice. And I can go wherever I like, right?
Within reason, yes. But I have a question for you.
Sure, sure. What do you want to know?
A hypothetical. Let's say the reactor core is melting down, and you're the only one who could stop it.
Is there something wrong with your reactor?
No, no, it's fine. Just pretend, so you can stop the meltdown. But you'd suffer from extreme radiation exposure. What would you do?
Well, whatever you'd like. If you don't mind, I'm anxious to look around.
Why are you here?
Just come here to lend a hand, right? I want to do whatever it takes to help out.
Give the Overseer's question some thought and really answer it.
Huh, fine. You want me to jump in a reactor for you guys? Please. Nobody's gonna do that.
If you're thinking about ripping us off, don't.
Listen, it's hell up there. If you really give me food and a place to stay, I'll be good. Just don't go expecting me to jump in a reactor for you.
I think we could use them in our vault.
As long as you guys are on the level, I'll give this thing a try. Honest.
I appreciate your candor. You can stay, but you're not what we're looking for. Go ahead and get acquainted with your new home. What a... colorful gentleman. Clearly, he won't work for our experiments. Here's hoping third time's a charm.
Just for clarification, what's specifically wrong with him?
An obvious liar would invalidate any subjective responses we need from a test subject. No, he just wouldn't do at all.
Let's do the next interview, then.
As you say. Hello. Welcome to your new home.
Wow. A real overseer. I am so happy to be here. Hi. My name is Clem.
Yes. Clem, is it? Before you settle in, I have some questions.
Oh, okay. Sure. I'll answer anything you like.
Well, that's good. Here's a scenario. You've been assigned guard duty. You know, stand watch and make sure outsiders don't breach the perimeter. But from inside the vault, you hear a woman screaming. What would you do?
You want me to guard something? Sure. I can do that. I can do that right now, if you want. But I don't hear any screaming, Lady Overseer.
Would you help the lady or not?
Yeah, sorry. Well, if you tell me to guard, I guard. And I won't leave my post unless you tell me to. Is that okay?
Another question for you. What can you tell me about your mother?
Oh, she passed. But she was nice. You would have liked her. She killed a mole rat once.
Really? That's remarkable. Describe the traits you most admire about her.
Well, she was strong because of the mole rat, and she fed me. God, I'm sorry. This place is so much better than the ditch I was living in.
Surely there are other traits you liked about her.
Well, no matter how bad things got, she put us kids first. She fought until the end, too.
We're looking for a volunteer, Clem. Someone to test some new devices that will help everyone. Are you interested?
You mean I can stay? I mean, yes! I'll help out. I like helping. That's me, Clem. Always willing to help out.
Yes. I think you'll do nicely. And no time like the present to commence.
Can we trade a few things?
Of course.
Now that we have, Clem, we are ready to begin. The first step is to get him properly equipped and dressed. There should be supplies in the welcome area near the entrance.
Clem, let's get you outfitted like a real vault dweller.
I'm just so excited to be here. I'll do good. You'll see.
Hey there.
Our first vault residence. What a moment. But on to business. Exercise is an inherently selfish activity. Instead of using every hour, every minute, to further the goals of the community, a resident instead improves their body past the minimum requirements. Vault Tec has devised a solution, the Power Cycle 1000. While you pedal, You provide raw power to the Vault. A perfect answer to an inherently counterproductive practice.
But doesn't society benefit from healthy citizens?
Overall, our research indicates it does not. True, some short-term medical costs are mitigated. But exercise leads to longevity, which extends how long the elderly drain the Vault's resources. No, exercise overall is a societal ill we should and can cure.
Settlements can always use power.
Precisely. The prototype is far from perfect. There were incidences during its R&D. Maybe even the stray cerebral hemorrhage.
What? Overseer?
Oh, Clem. Don't worry yourself. This model won't suffer from those defects.
Oh, good.
Well, probably. Let me download the schematic to your Pip-Boy. Build it and attach a terminal to choose the parameters of the experiment. Work Clem hard. Give me power.
Can we trade a few things?
I'm just so excited to be here. I'll do good. You'll see. Everyone's tired. We need more beds down here.
Push Clem to the limit. The power must flow.
Some people complain, but not me. Just happy to be here.
I'd like to trade some items.
I'm just so excited to be here. I'll do good. You'll see. This is all there is to it? So I'll keep peddling. This is kind of fun. What? The cycle is... Ow! Broken! I'll just keep pedaling.
Push Clem to the limit. The power must flow.
That power cycle really gets your heart beating. Like, really, really beating.
I just want to trade a few things.
I'm just so excited to be here. I'll do good. You'll see!
Push Clem to the limit. The power must flow.
Oh, man! I'm sorry! I broke your vault. I just got so excited and I wanted to do a good job and I kept pedaling faster and faster. And then the whole vault went kablooey. Please don't kick me out. There ain't enough beds to go around.
I was looking at the data for the power cycle. Marvelous work. The power cycle intelligently forced our test subject to pedal to his limits.
My heart's still pounding, Overseer.
Oh, cheer up, Clem. You could have pedaled at the rate of another 10 or 15 minutes without long-term effects.
If you say so.
For the next experiment, we'll need something from outside. Vault Tec subcontracted alchemical research to Hallucigen Incorporated. It was supposed to be delivered before. Well, before. But with the mail service out of commission, other arrangements must be made.
The whole world we knew died. Don't you care?
Enormously. That's why these experiments must succeed. We must make sure the inheritors of the Earth have every advantage.
I'll be back before you know it.
Excellent. Just grab a package for Overseer Barstow. Once we have that, we can start the next experiment.
Repeat. A chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately. detected. Please evacuate the building.
I have those chemical formulas for you.
Marvelous. Now we can reform another societal picadillo. The hydration break. Whether it rears its head around the coffee pot, water cooler, or soda fountain, it's a menace. Vault Tec scientists have conducted experiment after experiment to eliminate this inefficiency. But people feel an irrational need to socialize. So, if they must squander their time, let us turn it into the collective good. With chemistry.
What? Aren't chemicals bad for you?
Oh, Clem. You worry so much, my boy. Everything you eat and drink is made of chemicals, don't you know?
Oh, right. That's very interesting, Lady Overseer.
These are just special chemicals.
What type of chemicals are we talking about?
Well, that's up to you. But from what I've read, the R&D folks really outdid themselves.
It's okay. You can trust us, Clem.
Indeed. After all, we're with Vault Tec. So build the soda fountain, and then serve refreshments to our residents. And Clem, if you get thirsty on the job, feel free to have a cool, refreshing beverage.
Gee, thanks.
I guess I'm open for business.
Yes?
The soda fountain's open. Want to be the first customer?
Depends. How much does it cost?
Oh, it's free.
Really? Well, I guess then.
People are having to sleep in shifts.
Wow.
It's making everyone a bit cranky.
This soda's better than Nuka-Cola. Try it. You'll see. You here to check up? I got a customer right here.
Want some more refreshment?
What the heck's in there? I had a Nuka-Cola once. This stuff.
I know, right? It's got special chemicals in it.
No shit. Well, whatever it is, call me a fan.
Bye.
Caffeine. Well, it does improve productivity. But really, on to the next prototype. The Hippocratic Oath. A solemn vow to do no harm. Well, roughly, that's what it means. I don't want to get into interpreting dusty Latin textbooks, but that core sentiment of the medical community runs counter to what we're trying to accomplish here. Doctors shouldn't put their patients' welfare first. Instead, their sole focus should be the collective good. You understand, of course.
Times are desperate. We do what we must to survive.
What price isn't worth paying to protect the American way? Right. So, enter the Vault Tec Phoropter, a specialized piece of optometrist equipment that, yes, can improve a patient's eyesight, but potentially so much more. The prototype requires a bit, well, a lot. All right, a staggering quantity of radioactive material. But the results will be worth it.
Where am I going to get that much nuclear material?
You're in luck. We chose this site for Vault 88 because our surveys indicate that there's a rich source of uranium deeper inside the caves. So, dig deep and get what we need.
Some people complain, but not me. Just happy to be here.
Hey.
Looks like we have our first patient. Yes. Before we begin, Clem, how do you feel about children?
They're all right, I guess.
You ever planning on having any?
I don't know. Why are you asking?
Just idle chatter. Go on.
Hi! You here for an eye exam with the this thing?
I guess.
Go ahead and get in.
So, what do I do?
Just stay still.
It keeps flashing.
I think that's normal.
What? Ah! What the? Ow!
This thing's not working!
What were you doing? I kept saying obey the Overseer.
Well, that's just a quirk of the prototype. Nothing to concern yourself with.
Bullshit. This ain't the end of it.
Excuse me.
What the hell is your game? You invite Clem and me in here to experiment on us? You some sort of sicko?
There's nothing sinister going on. You're just imagining things.
You sure? I mean, that eye machine. All right. But I'm watching you.
I ain't never tasted, well, anything like Vault 88 soda.
So one of our residents is happy. That's completely irrelevant. We should be making hard choices to improve the effectiveness of the Vault. Instead, you spend your time pandering to their every whim.
Don't you want to make your residents' lives better?
The primary goal, the only goal, is to safeguard the American way and protect its people. I don't have the luxury of thinking about happiness.
I'm improving people's lives. I'm not going to apologize for that.
I just don't understand you. Please, make this next one count. This last experiment is my pride and joy. Following in the footsteps of Dr. Braun and the others, I have spent my time devising my very own prototype. Its premise is this. We are all flawed creatures, each with our own vices. What if our Vault didn't pointlessly try to stamp out these predilections, and instead harnessed them?
What vices are you talking about?
Well, greed. The schematic is for a slot machine. I designed it to be as enticing as possible. Choose the experimental parameters, and let's see how it fares in the field.
Things are a bit crowded. A few more beds would lift everyone's spirits.
I figured the last thing I'd be worried about in a vault is finding a place to sleep.
Yeah? Yeah.
Let's check in with Clem.
Oh, hi. Is the slot machine supposed to flash every now and again? I swear it makes strange noise and flashes.
You must be imagining things. A slot machine doesn't take pictures of people.
Now we just need a variety act and some crime bosses and our casino's set.
Ah, your famous wit. It's done. Finally. Hundreds of years of refining and planning. The results were mixed. But in science, you rarely wind up exactly where you were expecting. With my life's work done, I think I will deliver our schematics to other vaults to improve their lives.
The vaults I know about have all failed. They're empty, or worse.
The world's a big place, and you should never underestimate Vault Tec. I pass the mantle on to you. Guide Vault 88. To greatness. You're the overseer now. Please, take care of the vault.
The thing's broke. It keeps making these weird clicking noises.
Yes?
Done with all your experiments? I hope I did good. They were real interesting.
How are you doing, Clem?
I'm doing well. This vault's just the best. I haven't been attacked by mole rats. Not even once. Just happy to be here.
You really are a glass is half full kind of guy, aren't you?
Who? Me? Heck, I'd be happy just to have a glass. I guess you're the overseer now, right? Looking forward to giving the vault my best.